is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to be discussing the five defensive linemen that the Detroit Lions held workouts with today. So let's get it started. Welcome everybody to another video. Glad you guys are here, and today we're back again discussing some tryouts that the Detroit Lions are holding. Matt Patricia told us earlier in the week that the reason they do this is because they want to have a little list of players by position that if they have to go bring in some players during the season or in the near future, they have a list of guys already set up. I think it's a great strategy for the Detroit Lions. That's why they've been working out multiple positions, and now we see that defensive line as the position of focus in these latest workouts. And a lot of it probably has to do with Jayshon Cornell being placed on IR. Jayshon Cornell had to deal with a serious Achilles injury, the 7th round pick out of Ohio State, who I had some high hopes for, a guy that I thought could kind of move around the defense line a little bit. I thought he gave us a lot in the pass rush, which was huge, something that we could definitely use. And I thought, you know what, he wouldn't have a huge role, but he may have a little role. But now with him on IR, potentially out for the season, the Lions may want to add some depth. Now, they may not do it right now. They may not add any of these guys. It could be someone completely different, or they may not add depth at all. But it is good to learn about some of these players. If the Detroit Lions do sign any of these players in the near future, or whenever they would, we'll do a full breakdown of that player, but today we're just doing a quick little overview, and let me just say, there's some awesome stories in here that you guys are going to want to hear, so let's get into it. All right, the first guy we got is Josiah Coatney, who is a defensive tackle with Ole Miss, an undrafted free agent in this year's draft that signed with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Unfortunately, you know, once again, now he's available. He was a 3-year starter for Ole Miss, and he played in 35 out of the 36 games there. What's great about Josiah is that he can play both in a 4-3 and 3-4 defense. Now, Lions, for the most part, in the nickel, they play a 3-4 defense, right? For the most part, they do mix in sometimes four defensive linemen, especially near the goal line, so that's where he could be useful. But his ability to play both allows the Lions to move him all over the defensive line. In a 4-3, he's basically a defensive tackle. In a 3-4, he's a 3-4 defensive end. That versatility is great, and he's also taking snaps as a nose tackle. And we know Matt Patricia loves those guys that can move all around, so he's definitely someone that you have to keep an eye on. His best production in college did come when he was a 3-4 defensive lineman. He's basically known a little bit as a tweener because he's not super athletic to be basically an edge pass rusher, but he's also not the strongest guy, and he's not the biggest guy to play nose tackle. So he's a little bit of a tweener. He definitely needs an NFL home and an NFL scheme that can help him and kind of, you know, put him in one position, or an NFL scheme like ours that can move him around and he could be valuable in many different spots. He would probably be a solid depth guy for us, and he's very young, which is something that I really like. Two gap consistency, which is a little bit concerning in Matt Patricia's defense, but for the most part, I think this guy has some potential. He's a very young kid, and his ability to move around the entire defense line is something that Matt Patricia could like. He's 6'3", and he weighs over 300 pounds. And if you look at the Lions' defensive line, Danny Shelton is well over 300 pounds, but the defensive ends are not 300 pounds. So that's why you kind of get the tweener aspect there. So we definitely would have to pick something, try to focus on something in his game. But if there is a scheme that would like to have guys that can move all around, it's Matt Patricia's. That's Josiah. Next up, we have T.Y. McGill, who was a defensive tackle for NC State. He was an undrafted free agent signed back in 2015, so a little bit older. He is now 27 years old. He is 6'1", he weighs 293 pounds, so a little bit smaller than our guy Josiah. But get this, all right? This guy has been all around, okay? So you see some journeymen, right? Oh, yeah, he's played for 5 teams, 6 teams, 7 teams, 8 teams, heck, try 9 teams. Well, actually, for T.Y., he's played for 10 teams. Yeah, I'm not making that up. This guy has been on 10 NFL teams. 10 NFL teams. I'm not making that up. And he's only 27 years old, and his stats don't reflect that he's really even played in the NFL. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Nick Williams, right? Just bouncing around, can't find a home. And his size kind of reminds me of Nick Williams a little bit as well. Some of these tweener guys remind me of that. But yeah, he has not been able to find a consistent home. In 2017, he was arrested for possession of marijuana right before he signed with the Cleveland Browns. But that was in 2017, so I'm sure he has learned from that experience. But once again, man, if you want a guy that's probably going to adapt pretty well to moving, well, this may be that guy because he's used to it. Or maybe that's his problem and that's why he can't find a house.
A little rockier than this.
I was thinking the same thing.
He was on a team. Chuck Pagano said this about him. Usually the guys at his position don't put up a lot of stats. He does. So again, he's out there. You know, he's a guy that's available. He hasn't found a home. He hasn't found a consistent home. He's shown flashes, but there's definitely some things to work out there. And he's not the youngest guy. But if the Lions want to go get a veteran, and maybe they could go after this guy. We know Jayron Kearse has had some problems in the past, but you know, he's moved on. They had discussions with him, and that could be the same situation for T.Y. So we'll see if the Detroit Lions decide to bring him in. Let's continue to move down. Next up, we have Walter Palmore. Walter Palmore, who was a defensive tackle for Missouri. Mizzou, I love saying that. 6'3", 317 pounds. This is a big guy, all right? Now, yes, maybe he could play a little defensive end, but he's a big guy, okay? You can almost put him at nose tackle, and that's what's great about this size, if he can get to the quarterback. He was a 2-year player for Missouri. He was actually a JUCO transfer kind of like Glover Quinn. We talked about that. I wasn't able to find tons of information on him, unfortunately, so I don't have much to give you on this guy. So we're just going to leave it at that. And if the Lions sign him, well, we'll have to dig pretty darn deep. All right, the next guy we have is Elijah Qualls. Elijah Qualls, I hope I'm saying that right. He is a defensive tackle who's 6'1", 322 pounds. I think that's the biggest guy we've talked about so far. And you don't want to know what's crazy about that? Okay, this guy is 322 pounds, right? He played running back in high school. Think about that for a second, all right? Guess how big this dude was in high school. Dude weighed 260 pounds in high school. And he's playing running back? Oh, but you know what he had to say about that? He said it was too easy. He said it was too easy playing running back. He had over 1,300 yards, and it was just getting too easy to score touchdowns, so they put him on the defensive line. Yeah, it'd be hard to bring down a 260-pound running back. Yikes. Now, he is 322 pounds. It definitely shows you that he at least had some athleticism in his past, and maybe that helps him out with vision as a running back. I don't know. I thought I would just point that out. But yeah, man, it's pretty incredible, okay? He says he's a good run stopper, and he's a better pass rusher than people maybe give him credit for. He has the size. We know at one point, at least, he had the athleticism. So the Lions bring him in, I'm not sure. But I definitely want to see this guy play running back. Okay, I'm just going to leave right there. And then finally, we have a guy that probably has the most interesting story on here that a lot of people are going to want to hear. And this is Kevin Wilkins, who is a defensive end / defensive tackle. Okay, he's listed as a defensive end. The guy weighs over 300 pounds. I'm listing him as a defensive tackle. Out of Rutgers, 6'2", 25 years old. Now, basically, they sum this guy up as basically having the Blindside story. I don't know if you guys have ever seen the movie Blindside.
Nope.
I'm sure a lot of you guys have. It's a football movie. I like the movie personally. Not my favorite, but it's up there, right? Blindside's a good movie. And the reason they say it's like the Blindside story is because that's kind of how his childhood went, right? He was taken away from his mother at 6 years old. He was adopted. He ended up playing football in high school, and now he's in the NFL. So that's pretty incredible, right? He was on the practice squad in 2019 for the Giants. He was an undrafted free agent out of college, and now he's out there working out with some teams. I mean, I just got to give a round of applause for that on its own. That's incredible for going to that situation to make it into the NFL. And also, what's this crazy is that when he was with the Philadelphia Eagles on his first, you know, trip to rookie minicamp, right? He's, oh yeah, my NFL jersey's about to start. Well, no, actually 40 minutes away from home when he took off, his car basically blew up, right? It basically shut down on him. His mom had to come pick him up. So not the best start to his career, but man, I got to give him a lot of credit for the perseverance, man. That is incredible. He is a guy the Detroit Lions have worked out. I would love to bring him in just because of his story. I mean, that is awesome. But I will keep you guys up to date. Should the Lions sign any of these guys, I would love bringing in some depth. I don't think we know to go get a big name, go trade for someone big, but I'm good with adding depth because I think that could be very beneficial. Let me know your thoughts, comments below. Thank you for watching, and I'm out.